six overs to go. Ryan John is going to bowl to the Barbados Pride captain, Jason Oley, into bowl to hold a full toss with the way into the vacant square leg area for four. Square leg was short, but he just whipped that over square leg and down to the boundary for four. And just as I was saying, he gave away a free hit, or there's a free ball. And Holder is a big tall guy, just whipped that 246-5. Holder goes to 12.
Yes, not a good start here from Ryan John. Just giving Holder a nice full toss on the leg stump. And he has the up offside field, but he's moving on the outside.
Isn't that right, Ryan John? I'm just giving him some high praise, but he failed me. He's in now the bowl to Holder outside the off top corner. Missing the delivery where his left foot should maybe come across and be able to just squeeze that pass, cut the oil backward point. Talks to himself, Jason Holder. Not exploded in his championship yet. Maybe feels that you could see some fireworks from him. Carter is putting himself under a little bit of pressure. He wants to get that this day half century, but he needs more than this day half century right now. His team needs some runs. 246-5. Holder waits for Ryan John. In out the ball, Holder. It's a stop.
Thank you. especially by the parents, let us not come in every situation and trusting for the good. God loves us and the changes. Don't matter what problems we face or how unsettled life becomes, let us trust the God that never fails. He's in control. God is awesome. He's amazing. He's all powerful and full of compassion. He said he would not have us to be ignorant, brethren, concerning those which are asleep, that he sorrow not even as others which have become. For if we believe in that Jesus died and rose again, even so, then also the sleep in Jesus will God bring up. This text is very comforting. May it comfort each and every one of us here. To all Levi friends, we say, be encouraged. God isn't trying to change your mountains. He is using your mountains to change you. If you don't remember nothing in this message to you today, remember this one. A true friend is never truly gone. Their spirit lives on in the memories of those who love him. Today, we adopt you. So welcome into the Benoit family. To all his co-workers and lawyers, hats off to you. We applaud you. Jesus Christ, my Savior.
Thank you. and may the proverb bring comfort to those who mourn. In Jesus' name I stand. Amen.
Ladies and gentlemen, at this time, we call on Sister Philomena Roberts.
To view the body for the last time, and then we'll start.
with Chester, Senator Chester Humphrey, to just take 2 minutes to just view the body for the last time. May we have some musical interlude there?
Making money moves with the NLA's new Aces High Scratch Game. With 4 chances to win, beat the dealer's card to win the prize shown. Reveal an ace symbol. And just like that, you are automatically a winner. Scratch away to win the top prize of $10,000. Win easy with Scratch. Must be 18 or older to play.
Good day and welcome. It's time for the National Lottery Authority's Daily Pick 3 Midday Draw for today, Thursday, the 18th of February, 2021. I'm Lexanne Fletcher and I'll be your draw hostess for today. And standing in with me is Ms. Makiba Bain. She's representing PKF Accountants and Business Advisors. Of course, Ms. Bain is here to ensure the games for today are conducted in a fair and accountable manner, that the game balls have not been tampered with and are within industry standards. A quick reminder, as always, with the Pick 3 game, you can bet as little as $1 on inline, mix, and pair tickets, and from $2 on backup tickets. Let's find out what the winning numbers will be for today. It pays to play. Good luck. And the first number is first number 4. Second number 7. Third and final is 6. Let's recap, of course, numbers on the screen. First number was 4, the second number 7, third and final was 6. If you're a winner today, congratulations to you, and we want to shout out big congrats also to winners who were part of yesterday's payout. We had a total of 150 winners. The total payout was $26,350. Congratulations again, and do stay tuned. We've got the Playway draw coming up right after this. We'll see you then. Welcome back. It's time for the Playway draw for today, Thursday, the 18th day in February 2021. And joining me once again is Ms. Makiba Bain. She's representing PKF Accountants and Business Advisors. Well, here's a quick reminder with the Playway game. All you got to do is bet as little as $1 up to $10 on increments on any number or dream symbol of your choice and get to win 24 times the amount you bet. That's $24 for every dollar spent. It's time to reveal the winning Playway number for today. Value your dreams, win your way with Playway. Good luck. And the winning Playway number is for today is 18. That's 1818. The dream symbol is love making. Just a quick recap for the playway number. That number is 18. 1818. The dream symbol is love making. Congratulations to you if you're a winner today. Congratulations also to winners who were part of yesterday's payout. We had a total of 523 winners. The total payout was $49,056. Congratulations again. Well, certainly hope you've got those cash for tickets out and ready. That comes up next. See you then. Welcome back. It's time for the daily cash for draw for today, Thursday, the 18th of February, 2021. Miss Makiba Bain is standing in with me once again. She's representing PKF Accountants and Business Advisors. Well, don't forget, with the cash for game, you can bet as little as $1 on most of the bet types, with the exception of backup, in which case you bet $2. Let's find out what the winning numbers will be for today. It's more plays, bigger prizes. Good luck. And the first number up is 9, second number 2, third number 6, and the fourth and final is 5. All right, let's do a quick recap. First number up was 9, the second number 2, third number up was 6, and the fourth and final was 5. Congratulations if you're winning. Congrats to winners also part of yesterday's payout. There was a total of 55 winners. The total payout was $11,500. Big congratulations again, and don't forget to get those tickets for later on and continue to support sports culture and nation building. Have a great afternoon.
The Levi Benoit, Levi, and the Benoit family. The Honorable Leader, Member of Parliament for the Thomas St. George, Minister of Agriculture and Labor, Senator Andrew Lewis, Labor Representative in the Senate, President General of the Union, other parliamentarians that haven't seen any other, don't want to leave anyone else. This is Odette Campbell, best of the GDN, pastor of the Seventh Day Adventist Church. I know we were earlier intoned by the leader of the Seventh Day Adventist Church that we assemble not to mourn, but to celebrate life. While I respect that request and that dedication of purpose, death and funerals always evoke sadness. I cannot know your pain, but I can appreciate your grief. This evening I won't be very long, and I just want to encapsulate for all of us my journey with a friend and comrade, Levi Joshua Benoit. I came to know Levi through the trade union movement and the struggles which were waged during that period of time. All that was said by Sister Philomena, one of his co-workers, and I'm certainly certified by every worker who would have worked with Levi, is an absolutely true encapsulation of the individual Levi Benoit was.
You could not find a more cheerful person in the midst of difficulties. And let me tell you something. On this journey, Levi and I had difficulties. I don't know how many of you recall the great GBM struggle. And the many days we were on strike. And the fact that every single worker was then dismissed by the company. And in the midst of all of that, as the workers assembled on a daily basis in Tamu's house, Levi was the cheerleader. He kept everybody's spirit high. And you know, in the middle of a trade union struggle, a leader carries an enormous burden. Because you are responsible not only for every worker whom you call on strike, but you are also responsible for the family and the welfare of each one of those workers. So it's a heavy burden. And I had to rely on Levi, and that's when I got to know him. A dedicated individual, a serious individual under that smile, a hard worker, a person who is committed to his fellow man. And I think that's the essence of Levi's life, that he was committed to his fellow man. Any GBN worker today who enjoys union security rights and function, who enjoys the payment of overtime, who enjoys the payment on split shifts, who enjoys redundancy and severance, most importantly, any worker who enjoys pensionable benefits, Levi's thumbprint is on that benefit because he was in the forefront of the struggle to secure those. Even after I departed the union, that struggle continued. And thanks to the significant intervention of the Minister of Labor, after many years of struggle and toil, workers at the GBN eventually got a retirement benefit, and they enjoy a pension when they are departed, something which did not exist before and for which we struggled many years and had significant strike struggles for this. Any worker who receives a bonus from the GBN, I want you to think about Levi, because his fingerprint and his effort is on that bonus. Any worker who finds himself in a classification scale, able to move up, think about Levi, because it was his struggle that contributed to that benefit. And of course, derived from your employment is your income for which you look after your family. So that for every GBN worker, no matter if there is some disaffection with salary, the fact is, you are a fortunate worker that knows exactly when your PD arrives. It may not be a sum that you will want to sing loudly about, but think about the hundreds, the thousands, who have no particular day of a PD because they're unemployed. So while Levi would have departed us, he has left a very rich legacy of service to his fellow workers. I know much will be said about him by other speakers, so I will be brief. But ladies and gentlemen, congregants, this is my brief recollection of his journey with a comrade and friend, Levi Joshua Edward. Unfortunately, I may have to take my leave at the end. I'm a migraine sufferer and I'm into a migraine phase, but I could not have allowed this last favor to Levi to go without me saying a few words. Thank you for your indulgence. Thank you. Yeah.
No, no, I'm not trying to include us. But though he has left, I still want to recognize the presence of, then presence of, President of the Senate, Conor Chester, the immediate past President General of Tamil, Minister for Labor and Agriculture, Comrade Peter Pedro David, Consul General, Comrade Derek James, Odette Campbell, Managing Director of GBN, Dr. George Mitchell, a COVID Response Coordinator, Cancer Director, and Mrs. Mitchell. Esther, my sister, friend, family, like a long way. Yeah. And GBN comrades and friend. Good afternoon, all. The Grenada Technical and Allied Workers Union, its Management Committee, Secretariat, General Counsel and rank and file, extend heartfelt condolences to the family, co-workers and friends on the loss of our beloved Comrade Levi Benoit, Shop Steward and General Counsel Delegate, who represented the workers at the Grenada Broadcaster Network. Comrade Levi became a member of the Grenada Technical and Allied Workers Union in September of 1998 as an employee of the Grenada Broadcaster Network, to which he gave almost 35 years of continuous service. Quite a number of us, people don't make it there. Still in one of ways. Speaks about loyalty and commitment. Comrade Levi Benoit, or Levi, as you are fondly called, was an activist and leading participant in the Tau versus GBN battles of April and May 2000, and then in 2003, among other activities. As a short show and general counsel, delegate of Tau, he gave consistent, committed, and dedicated service to the workers of GBN and the wider working class of Grenada, Karakou, and Dimatic. Levi was the live wire, keeping the morale of the workers up. He never looked or sounded worried or defeated. He was always quick to pull up and comfort anyone who showed any signs of concern. His dead woman, Sherry Hill, of the long step, was the center of entertainment, food, drink, music, and most of all, jokes, for so with Comrade Levi Starry. Here's the centerpiece. Comrade Tony, Colleen, Andre, another comrades, and one that is not here but is still present in spirit, Comrade Martin. Do us what it is, and Levi was one of the main persons. As a matter of fact, Levi was part of a special squad. And I use that word deliberately and with absolute knowledge. One of these stories may be told, of things that needed to be done to ensure that these battles were won. And he was part of that squad that was always present and committed. He was one of the main driving force in the fighting and securing of the past service benefit for workers with long years of service, which is a tweaking of pension. There's a group of workers who made many, many years of service to GBN. And as Comrade Humphrey mentioned earlier, that struggle was eventually won in December of 2019 with the efforts of our dear comrade, Minister for Labor, Pedro, Peter, a most recognized that comrade. And Levi was an integral part. As a matter of fact, I have hardly come across anyone with so much passion, and I mean real passion, passion to the point of sometimes, if we are not careful, we all may fall, right, in the way that he's making this passionately for the benefits of the people at GDM. This insistence led to these workers being eligible for payment for the years of service. He really displayed passion, as I said. January 26th, let's fast forward because there are many people to speak. January 26th, that's less than a month ago. Our union met with the GBN to discuss matters of interest to the workers. Comrade Levi was supposed to be present and part of the meeting, along with Comrade Sister Bonnet, Colonel Celestine, both of whom are sharp shots. Not seeing Levi, I called him, and he answered, only to be told, watch now, I'm covering a matter at the court, and then if I have time, I will pass, but don't watch that. B could handle, and she could give me a brief. All said in his usual job, such as his confidence and his commitment to the work. In other words, if B was not present, I'm absolutely certain that he would not have been covering the story, he would have been present. But he married both, did the work, and had absolute confidence in his riding B, Bonnet. One of Comrade Levi's last engagement with the working class struggle was his coverage as a camera operator of the joint press conference organized by the Grenada Public Workers Union, Grenada Union of Teachers, and the Grenada Technical and Allied Workers Union, held on Thursday, January 28th, the attention to the date, 2021, to address the public sector workers' fight for the 4% salary increase. Comrade Mikey, perhaps you remember that. Yes, remember that, and the other media personnel who were there. That said night, he was taken to the hospital while waiting to go to his home. In a very sad and touching manner, similar to his very good buddy and comrade, Martin Redhead. Martin's engagement with us at work, like was in the struggle of the graduate workers. These comrades had one thing in common. They have given everything to the commitment for working people and the family. The next morning, Friday, January 29th, I got a call from his wife, Esther, informing that he was at the ICU and things were not looking good. Given the uncertainties of life and discussing concerns with senior officers at the union office, I journeyed to the ICU at the General Hospital and paid respect and tribute to our comrade Levi on behalf of myself as a friend and comrade and that of the union. Comrade Andre Jerome was also with me. Fate had it, life had it, that we both ended up outside the hospital together and we made our way. Comrade Esther, tough time. I want to thank you and the family for ensuring that I was able to be given the opportunity to visit him while he was sedated. And there is some branch of medicine which says that even in that process of sedation, the person is still conscious of what is happening. So I give adequate tribute to him, thank him for everything that he did, not in the past tense, right? But making the point that we are going to see you soon. Have nothing to do with what I mean. But having to pay that tribute, and it was an honor and a dignity for us. As it turned out, we went, and we paid our last respect to him, calling on the names of the different comrades, Andre, Tony, B, and everyone, telling him that they send their love and get well wishes for him. Monday morning, February 1st, 2021, I received a call which said that it took a turn for the worse, and the doctors wanted the family to come to the ICU immediately. Our union flag, our union is flying this flag in combination with a black flag as a mark of respect and mourning on the passing of Comrade Levi Benoit. This will be flown beyond his burial day today. Given the restriction brought about by COVID, the Technical and Allied Workers Union family is not able to be present here today to bid farewell to our dear Comrade Levi. The union has circulated to its membership the live link so that his funeral service can be followed virtually. And I'll take the liberty, comrades and family, to thank all those who made it possible for us to have this turnout here today. We need to recognize that. And it speaks to the comrade and the person that Levi was. He was not just belong to his immediate family, but belong to Grenada. Because after giving 35 years of service, he was a household name and a household face in the Grenadian house and community. Today, our union mourns the loss of a comrade, husband, father, brother, and friend, Levi, and once again expresses deepest heartfelt condolences to his wife, Esther Benoit, stepdaughter Cody Buckner, who was a gem of his heart. I mean, just every time I hear Levi, it's Cody, Cody, Cody. Co-workers and loved ones. Levi was part of the Tahoe Secretariat staff, and there was no bunks for Levi. Levi was just part of the Tahoe Secretariat staff. But he was not just only a comrade and a brethren and a friend and a committed soldier of the working class. In terms of his deep commitment and connection to the Tahoe Secretariat, we also express our condolences to our own member of staff, Sister Annie Tuesday-Nicholas, who grew up like a sister with Levi. As a matter of fact, she bore the brunt of Levi's jests and jokes. Yes, and trust me, Levi could be terrible. Levi could tell you anything, and you can't get back to them. Our dear comrade Levi, you are indeed a genuinely nice human being. We in Tahoe salute your memories. Long live the memories, comrade Levi Benoit. Rest in perfect peace, my dear friend and comrade. May you soon rest in peace. Thank you very much.
And we must pause until it comes back to us. Walk with big man, for you are and always will be our head Hebrew in charge.
Oh. can I read progress from the speech she could make it? We all know the situation of COVID, and you can see that she's in a lot of pain. We'll have on the next tribute from Dr. Mitchell on behalf of Don Benham.
Thessalonians 4:13-14 tells us, death is asleep.
He said he would not have us to be ignorant, brethren, concerning those which are asleep, that he sorrowed not even as others which have been born. For if we believe in that Jesus died and rose again, even so, then also with sleeping Jesus will God bring with him. This text is very comforting. May it comfort each and every one of us here today. To all Levi friends, we say, be encouraged. God isn't trying to change your mountains. He is using your mountains to change you. If you don't remember nothing in this message to you today, remember this one. A true friend is never truly gone. Their spirit lives on in the memories of those who love him. Today, we adopt you. You are now all our friends. So welcome into the Benoit family. To all his co-workers and lawyers, hats off to you. We applaud you.
God will never take us when the grace of God
will not protect us. So, to all beloved family, his wife Esther, his daughter Cody, and all our dear friends, we say, cheer up, cheer up. We have a hope that lives within our heart, hope in the coming of our Lord. At our lowest, God is our hope. At our weakness, God is our strength. At our saddest, God is our comforter. Only God can turn a mess into a message, a test into a testimony, a trial into a triumph, a victim into a victory. Today, our sweet brother, Levi Benoit, you are our victory. Sleep in peace. We love you in life, and we will love you in death. We will always love you forever. Sleep. You will never, ever be forgotten. Rest in peace, brother. We love you.
Now have a slideshow from which we are coming.
Rest in peace, Levi. The family stays strong. God bless. all those good times spent here in this kitchen, the laughter, fun, the good old days. You will truly be missed, boss Levi.
Most of the time that I was around Levi was spent smiling, because despite the situation, whether it was work related, whether it was personal, he always found a way to make you feel better. He would say, girl, life is tough, but you gotta do what you gotta do, and you gotta stay focused. You know, you'll always give you an encouraging word, and he will be missed. Up to the time of his passing, he went on, not colleagues, but because of the bond that was formed, friendship, he felt like family, you know.
Charge. I would say, made a very valuable contribution to the media landscape in Grenada, and he will be missed. May his soul rest in peace.
All the memories I have of Levi, who would lovingly answer whenever I called him Leviticus, are filled with laughter, joy, pure entertainment. And I knew that about Levi even before I started working at GBN. And the 3.5 years that I actually got to work with Levi, I witnessed it firsthand. Levi was just a joy to be around. It had to grasp. But Levi is a person. He's not easy to forget. Never. Love you, Leviticus.
Once Levi entered that building, one was sure that the day was about to be turned all the way up to 100. With fun, frivolity, jokes, laughter, and camaraderie. I can picture Levi right now as he entered the studio. His laughter would be heard from the hallway or from the yard, or his characteristic watch, 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 pointed in one direction or the other. I want us to remember that Brother Levi was a cornerstone of the institutional legacy of GPN in so many respects. Rest in peace, Levi. The media landscape in Grenada is better because he lived.
As painful and sudden as his transition was, I'm sure you would have reflected on the moments you've shared together. How he impacted on us as a husband, a brother, co-worker, colleague, and for many a friend. His life was short, but the memories were lasting. Always reliable, respectful, kind, and helpful.
Also deceased. After 4 days,
hospitalization at the St. George's General Hospital. He died on Monday, February 1st, 2021. As with all of us, he had a journey. He went to school and he worked. From a child, Levi was mentally and emotionally strong. Growing up, the economic situation at home was sometimes challenging. And Levi, though he was one of the youngest of his siblings, he became an example among them. Every one of his siblings with whom he lived and grew up remember him as a very loving brother who never found it hard to share his food, his toys, or whatever else he had. Even as a child, he was never a person who got vexed easily. That attribute remained with him into adulthood. And if you keep telling him something over and over, he will say, "Talk now. You think I'm bothering with you?" And he would start laughing. He always kept the family laughing. He was always happy and jolly. Levi attended his SDA school at Archibald Avenue. And upon completion of his schooling, he found employment at a media company as a security guard at Discovery TV. He was ambitious. When an opening for a cameraman at Grenada Broadcasting Network presented itself, he jumped at the opportunity and was recruited and trained. Levi was employed with the GBN, Grenada Broadcasting Network, as a camera operator or driver for well over a quarter of a century. Over the years, he became probably the most reliable and competent cameraman among the GBN camera crew. The Media Association acknowledged that on numerous occasions, he acted voluntarily as a reporter and posed questions to the panelists. Not only that, but he also acted as a guide for young camera operators and reporters whom he came in contact with. All these efforts were done selflessly and voluntarily. Levi was a tireless worker who never ceased to amaze. In addition to his heavy workload and all of the numerous voluntary efforts, Levi also did part-time work as a court bailiff and represented his fellow workers as a shop steward and one of the trade unions. We remember Levi as a son who loved to take care of his parents. In the final years of his dad, he made it his duty to take his dad to the beach every weekend when his mother was sick. And when his mother was sick, he used to sit by her bedside and feed her. As a brother, he always looked out for all his siblings and made sure we were all fine. We could call on him at any time and he would always respond. Up to his death, he remained a sanctuary of resort and support. Recently, his big brother, Stanley, lost one of his hands, and Levi supported him throughout, picking him up most of the times, taking him to work with him, and dropping him back home. He would take him to the doctor to purchase his groceries, and then he will make a little fun of it by calling his big sister in New York and say to her, "Okay, I dropped your brother back home and he's okay. I took him to the doctor today," or wherever he took him, he would explain everything to his big sister and they would laugh over it. If a brother or sister is unwell or something is bothering them, he would call regularly to see how they were doing. He was very friendly and had lots of friends. On the whole, he treated people the way he wanted others to treat him. Levi was steady and stable. He was trustworthy. He was reasonable and even-handed. He was organized and orderly. He was a giver, a guardian, and a guide. Levi was strong. Everyone agrees that he gave consistent, committed, and dedicated service to the workers of GBN, the law courts, the trade union movement, and to the communities and to the Grenadian society at large. Levi was indeed a genuinely an amazing, wonderful human being. He left to mourn his wife, Esther, brothers Stanley Benoit in Grenada, Augustus and Lincoln Roberts in the US, and Smith Roberts, sisters Carolita, Margaret and Eileen in the US, Estella Martin in Trinidad, and Don Michelle, Devon Elizabeth, and Aria in Canada. His aunts, Joan and Anne, his stepdaughter, Cody Bachmeyer, several nieces and nephews, and brothers and sisters-in-law, friends and neighbors. Levi's life reflected this quote by William Penn, who said, "I expect to pass through life but once. If therefore there be any kindness I can show, or any good thing I can do to any fellow being, let me do it now, and not defer or neglect it, as I shall not pass this way again." May his soul rest in peace. Now have a scripture reading from Isaiah chapter 40, verses 28 to 31. And it reads, "Hast thou not known, hast thou not heard, that the everlasting God, the Lord, the creator of the ends of the earth, fainteth not, neither is weary? There is no searching of his understanding. He giveth power to the faint, and to them that have no might, he increaseth strength. Even the youth shall faint and be weary, and the young man shall utterly fall. But they that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings as eagles. They shall run and not be weary, and they shall walk and not faint." This is the reading of the Word of God.
At this time, we're going to have a musical tribute by Sister Estella.
Yeah. rather short but very pointed reading for today. You listen to the tears and you see the tears and you feel them. You hear the comfort of the words of Revelation, chapter 21, verse 4. And God will wipe away every tear from their eyes. There shall be no more death, nor sorrow, nor crying. There shall be no more pain, for the former things have passed away. The word of the Lord.
it down solid. And ladies and gentlemen, I am delighted to be associated with these two gentlemen up here. The taller one on my extreme left. Why do you laugh? Why do you laugh? All right. As I was saying before, you interrupted me, that the tall one across there, his name is Pastor Charles Gittins. Pastor Gittins, will you please just give him a view? All right, so you see how tall he is. All right. The other gentleman, Pastor Marlon Peters, he's going to do the sermon. Yeah. Pastor Peters is a son of the soil. As a matter of fact, he hails from the Brisbane Bush Issue area. He is a young pastor with the Grenada Conference of Seventh-day Adventists. He's been a graduate of University of the Southern Caribbean. So he's a strong kid on the block. This afternoon he's going to soothe you. He's going to tell you what the Lord expects of you. So I now invite Pastor Marlon Peters.
Leave drunkards behind. rapists behind, child molesters behind. Why? Don't know. But today my friends are not here to speak to you. Brother Levi, he can't hear me. Truth is, I wish he could have. But he can't. And therefore, there are a few things that Brother Levi wants me to tell you. And here's the reason why I'm here. Oh, your heavenly Father. Today we pause and say, thank you. Lord, we're here grappling with emotions. But we still believe that you are in existence. And God, I pray that you will just speak to the members of the family and all those who are here a word of comfort that will take us forward even now. In Jesus' name we pray. I want to share with you briefly from the Word of God in the book of 1 Corinthians. 1 Corinthians. Chapter number 15. Reading from verse number 51 unto 55. A reading you're hearing from the Word of God. The Bible says, behold, I show you a mystery. We shall not all sleep, but we shall all be changed. In a moment, in the twinkling of an eye, at the last trump, for the trumpet shall sound, and the dead shall be raised incorruptible, and we shall be changed. For this corruptible must put on incorruption, and this mortal must put on immortality. So when this corruptible shall put on incorruption, and this mortal shall put on immortality, then shall be brought to pass the saying that is written, death is swallowed up in victory. O death, where is thy sting? O grave, where is thy victory? This afternoon, my short discourse is entitled, The Day That Death Lose Its Sting. The day death lose its sting. Ladies and gentlemen, I want to start off by saying, death has no friend. Death takes no bribe. And death must visit all of us. Death has no friend. Death takes no bribe. And death must visit all of us. You can eat all the cabbage and tomatoes and lettuce and sweet peppers you want. It is coming. You can jog from St. George's to St. David. It is coming. You can visit the doctor as often as you want. It is coming. You can be prepared mentally as much as you want. It is coming. Death respects no one. I've buried individuals that are only 2 hours old, 6 months old, 2 years old, 3 years old, 30 years old, 25 years, and just keeps going up. It tells me as a young man that death has no friend. Death respects no one. And death is coming. But Levi this evening wants me to tell you 3 things. Before death lose its sting. You see, I did my etymological study of the word Levi. Levi, Pastor Gittins, tells me it is a priestly tribe. Levi, the word Levi means to join in harmony. Yeah. Today, only three things, very briefly. I realize that some persons today want the pastor to go in jail for the school they put about. Notice they only give us about 1.5. But we way past that. And as you can see, Dr. Mitchell is near and gone, he don't want to be part of that. Thank you, Jesus. But I did not hold you here for too long. Just bear with me for a few minutes. The Bible gives us some words of assurance that Levi wants to share with you. That over 6,000 years now, humanity is suffering with this whole thing we call death. It is one of the longest standing traditions. Yet, mankind can get used to it. We just can't get accustomed. It baffled the mind of Job, the oldest book in scripture. He searched to find answers as it relates to death. And Job came to his own personal conclusion. If a man died, the person asked as he battles with him, shall he live again? But Job also tells us, chapter number 19, verse number 25, that he shall wait his appointed time, because Jesus himself will come. Friends, today you are here, Sister Esther, you are here, believe it or not, Jesus himself will come. The first thing that Levi wants to share with us today and wants us to understand is that we must understand the focus. What is the focus? The focus, Levi says, is for Grenadians to be focused. He wants us to understand that a weather pattern is bad. He wants us to understand that the things are rough. And it's getting more and more rough. Levi, we got to focus because the focus is bad. How do you know, Pastor, that the focus is bad? When I can see a man raping a little child, the focus is bad. When I see men trying to be women, the focus is bad. When I see great things in our society that is accepted, the focus is bad. When I see parents disowning children in this postmodern era, I can tell the focus is bad. When I see the great despair just through the pandemic, it tells me that the focus is bad. And therefore, my friend, Levi is saying to us, rather than concentrating on the focus, let us be focused.
All right.
Levi taught us that in the midst of peril, you can still laugh. He taught us there is always room to make yourself merry. In GDN, it is one set of individuals that I respect very dearly, our media workers. They toil daily, momentarily, because the information that they want to bring, they want to ensure that it is the right one. Lord have mercy. Today, we are living in an environment where COVID is not killing the most persons that are dying presently today. Mr. Pastor, what are you saying? Cancer is not killing most persons that are dying today. What are you saying, Pastor? Diabetes is not killing the most persons that have been pronounced dead today. No, misinformation is killing the universe. Misinformation. And therefore, it tells me that Levi believes in service to humanity. Hence the reason why he joined himself with GDN or whatever network to ensure information is true. Today, my or their brother would have labored in the cause for GDN. He leaves with all of us here, workers, helping us to understand that the fight for truth must continue. I'm afraid to look at social media these days. As a matter of fact, I'm just blocking people constantly. just misinformation. You just pick up something on the road and you post it on Facebook and it becomes gospel. So I'm very careful as to what I look at and what I read today. And that's the reason why I don't take anything unless I see it from authentic sources. The second thing that Levi wants us to understand today, that in order to hold death accountable, we all must be changed. The Bible says so in verse number 53, for this corruptible must put on incorruption, and this mortal must put on immortal. To understand death and to judge death, we shall all must be changed. We must be changed. In a twinkling of an eye, verse number 52 says, in the twinkling of an eye, at the last trump, not Donald Trump. For the trumpet shall sound, and the dead shall be raised incorruptible. The dead, according to 1 Thessalonians, that shall be raised incorruptible, are those persons who leave planet earth being obedient to the will of God. Because remember, death started through disobedience. Yes. Therefore, life must be given through obedience. Yes. The Bible says in 1 Thessalonians chapter 4 and verse 16, for God himself shall descend from heaven with a shout, with the voice of the angel, and with the trumpet of God, and the dead in Christ shall rise first. Yes. Yes. I ain't about you, but if there is a dead in Christ, there is a dead somewhere. Yes. I don't know, but I always look left. I never set my feet on anyone because it's just too much. And I ever feel it. I saw a lady crying up the stairs, and I said, I understand your pain, sister, in my mind. Mass and no mass.
But not just here, you know, at televisions as well. And you will see the same thing across the globe. They are petitioning before the GG in Madrid for Carvalho. He was with him. It is time, my friend, for us to take stock as to where we are and where we are going. Today, death is just calling individuals. I don't know when my number will call, but I want to ensure that when my number is called, I'm being obedient to the will of God.
Amen.
This is a test to humanity. We must stand for something, or else we fall for anything.
Amen. But Levi grew up in an environment where we learned very early that you gotta work for what you want. My friends, a lot of us, I'm inclusive of myself, as young people, we don't know what it means to work for what you want. We probably know what it means to be reliant on mama's house until she died. We are living today and we don't know how to work. I'm so sorry to see. Some of us don't know how to cook. Ramen is the order of the day. And that is close on some family is in trouble. Because we are buying it and warm it at home for him. I'm afraid because some of us will not live that long. We will not because we don't eat properly. Young people today, you can't even give us young feed and young blood anymore. Give us rice and macaroni that has been processed. With you, but COVID is teaching this world a lesson.
Yes.
How things can change in the twinkling of an eye.
Yes.
And together with COVID, death is so sudden. Today we are, tomorrow we are not. Just 2 weeks ago, one of my good friends was buried at age number 36. School together. Didn't have long to find the reason of his death. God showed next week he died. 36. I thought sure used to take 18 years and above. 16 and above. 36. I found next one in the hospital, as I'm speaking to you, blood clot. Doctor says if you move, you're gonna have attack. You can't move. Young boys, he's less than 36 now. He's about 21, somewhere there above. This is the time that we are living in. It is time for us to pause and say, God, honor myself. It is time for us to stop and think and reconsider as to where we are going and what we achieve where we are going. But Levi wants us to change.
Yes,
Levi wants us to change.
Yes.
The third thing I leave with you. Levi wants us to understand that death will be brought before a tribunal. It is time to understand the merit in this thing that we call death. Death is wicked when death will sweep away a loved one from the wife or husband. Death is a terrible thing when it will go with months old baby. Death terrible. Death is a dread.
this thing is with. I've been home to family every week. And I can tell the impact of this thing that got rum. Rum is a wicked thing. Rum is leading us down to the drain. To the drain of death. Rum is condemning families, mashing up families. Rum is causing people to have impure judgment. Alcohol is destroying our nation. Today our young friends are drinking in school. I remember just not too long ago, we couldn't send a child to purchase alcohol in the shop. The bartender wouldn't sell. Just this week I have to pull up on the family. The child is carrying a stag to them. And I said, are you crazy, my brother? And you want to kill the child and the child starts drinking at it.
My friends, but I thank God. Yet you have to answer. I'm not a concern about this body. It shall soon turn on. But what I do know, I thank God, which giveth us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. Death will be conquered. Death can be conquered. What we ought to do is it is to live in accordance to the will of God. I believe, my sister, Sister Carl, that Brother Benoit would have made right with Jesus. It is my only human sanctified imagination. I believe that he would have made right with God. If I had the power to put persons in heaven and hell, I surely would have put them in heaven right away. And Sister Esther, if he's there, you have to be ready. If he's there, I want to give him a high five again at the resurrection. I want to give him a hug again and say, brother, by next time don't do us that. You have gone too early. You see, my friends, we ought not to be fearful of this. We just got to be ready that it is coming. I always say, as I sit to close, when I die, I want to go away with you. I want you to bury God on top of me. I want to bury sheep on top. Both. Anything you can bury, just bury it on top. The Bible says, at the sound of the trumpet.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
When Jesus sung the trumpet, yes. He shall cause my name come forth. And I want mine to be dramatic. Because I know if any old thing is placed upon me, that young man that will be buried on top of me, I said, move, boy. Yes. I want to pass. That child of Lester that will be placed upon me, move, God. But that day is coming. Brother Levi was above us, all of us. We all dearly miss him. I enjoy when he pulls the big hand. Watch that guy, he's putting it at him and he's smiling. Brother Levi was a tough son of the son. But you know what he's saying to us? Do not weep as persons without hope. But weep as individuals who have hope.
Yes.
To know just one of these days. Just one of these days at the sound of the trumpet, we shall all be changed. I don't know about some persons today. I can't live in this life without Jesus.
Amen.
It is the only security and surety of hope.
Yes.
I analyze, I sit and I analyze life. You live, you work out your soul. When it's time to die, you retire. But to judge death, we gotta live a life that is acceptable to God.
Yeah.
We shall all be changed. God bless us all.
Pastor Peters stands for the Lord. And I know that we concur with that statement, thanks a lot for the word. Only Jesus can keep us. And definitely, we have to live a changed life in order to be able to judge death. At this time, I pray and ask for comfort, especially on behalf of those blood relatives, well-wishers, and friends. Let us stand for prayer. Dear God and Father, you have pointed out in your word that no grave will hold our bodies down. You have pointed out in your word through the preacher that we can look forward to someday when Jesus Christ will return. You have pointed out in your word that those who want to be victorious over death have to make sure that they live changed lives. You have pointed out in your word that someday soon, individuals who would have changed their focus and the forecast, even though it's difficult now, they will have a different focus, and that focus would be lifting up their eyes towards heaven, from whence cometh their help. Our help cometh from the Lord our God. Father, today, please comfort your people, close relatives of Brother Levi, and help us to throw off any judgmental attitude, but help us to understand that even though in this world we have tribulation, we can be of good cheer, understanding that Jesus Christ has conquered death already. And so, to all loved ones, all Father, all loved ones, please comfort them. Help them to understand that even though the young may faint and be weary, those that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings as eagles, and they shall run and not be weary, they shall walk and not faint. So please grant the loved ones today that strength and that comfort that they are in need of, that only you, God, can give. Father, we understand clearly that death has been cast upon mankind because of sin. But when we read the text, the wages of sin is death, we understand also the promised part of the text that says that the gift of God is eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord. And so please comfort those who mourn today with the promised part of the text, eternal life. Help that they will hold on to you, whom to know is life eternal. And so, Father, as we repeat this afternoon those comforting words, comfort and strengthen relatives with those comforting words that say, let not your heart be troubled. Ye believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you, Jesus Christ said. And if I go to prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you unto myself, that where I am, there you may be also. Help that those listening to this promise and to the spoken word by Pastor Peters this afternoon will make that decision. I don't want to be left out of the kingdom of God. So I'm going to make sure I live a changed life and I live an overcomer's, the overcomer's life, so that I can see Jesus Christ when he comes. Until then, bless your people and comfort your people, I pray, in Jesus' name. Amen. God's blessings be upon you.
Kindly be seated. At this time, we call on Janelle, and she will tell us where we go from here.
Good afternoon again, everybody. Well, from here, we'll be going to the cemetery, the Center St. George's Cemetery. But before that, I would just like to say thank you on behalf of the Benoit family and you all, to all of you who would have attended, our online viewers. We appreciate your support, all the support, all the prayers. We thank you. If I left anybody out, please forgive me. Also, the eulogy was written by his brother, Smith Roberts, and his sister, Dawn Benoit. I forgot to say that when I read it. So I'm just giving them their due. Okay. We'll now have our closing hymn. 633, when we all get together.
Continue in the cemetery, folks. That's where we will continue, in the cemetery.
Welcome to the Shopping Guide, the place where you can find the best products and services in Grenada.
Are you a small business and would like your business to grow? Do you have an event, products, or services that people should know about?